Hi, and welcome to another Lunch and Learn brought to you by Bergson Flynn. Now, during these Lunch and Learns, we typically are trying to convey information to our past clients, our present clients, and our potential clients by giving them really valuable information about the world of litigation, real estate, and small business. A little transition here. And today we're going to talk to law students, prospective law students, young lawyers, existing lawyers, about practical skills that are really important in order to be a successful litigator, whether you're a prosecutor, whether you're a defense attorney, whether you're a plaintiff's attorney, or whether you're a civil defense attorney. These are things to keep in mind if you want to really excel in litigation. So today we're going to start at the beginning, or at least the beginning of the trial, and we're going to talk to you about opening statements. And what we're going to talk to you about is how, in broad strokes, to craft a really effective opening statement. And that's going to comprise of 5 points. We're going to talk to you about using the opening statement to organize your case for the jury. We're going to talk about providing the jury with a really compelling opening to the opening statement. We're going to talk about telling the story, a compelling narrative, over the course of your opening statement. We're going to talk about using the opening statement as a time to identify weaknesses to the jury. And we're going to talk about ending that opening statement with a flourish. Now, I wanted to use kind of a model case to illustrate some points over the course of this talk. And when I was a prosecutor, I used to be obsessed with talking about the Wizard of Oz during my jury selection process, sometimes during opening statements. I felt like everybody really knew what the Wizard of Oz, whether you were young or old, you could identify with it. Of course, first of my sitting in front of the jury and talk about the Wizard of Oz, nobody in the jury had any idea what I was talking about. But I'll try it again with you, and maybe some of you out there know what the Wizard of Oz is. So our test case is people of the state of New York, we will abbreviate first, Dorothy Gale. Dorothy Gale, of course, being the title character. From the Wizard of Oz, the title character, but the main character of the Wizard of Oz, Dorothy, and the crime that she's being charged with in our model opening statement is the killing of the Wicked Witch of the West. So I'm going to speak to you from the standpoint of a prosecution opening statement, but as I'm going through this, you should be thinking about it from a defense perspective, whether on the civil or criminal side, or if you're a plaintiff's attorney and this was a wrongful death action, how you could apply these same techniques to that kind of an opening statement as well. So the first thing that's really critical is you want to use the opening statement as a way to organize your case. A jury walks into a courtroom for the first time, they have no idea what's going on, they have no idea what to expect, and there are all these facts that you know really well as the attorney, but you should really know pretty well, otherwise you're in some trouble. And you have to kind of quickly and in a compelling way provide the jury with a roadmap. If you don't provide them with a roadmap, they're not going to understand how the witnesses that you call or the witnesses that you cross-examine over the course of the case are going to fit into the bigger picture. So in the same way that I provided you with a roadmap at the beginning of this talk, with these 5 points, you're going to want to organize your case for the jury really at the beginning of your opening statement. You know, over the course of this case, we're going to prove to you that Dorothy is guilty beyond a reasonable doubt of murder. We're going to do that through our witness testimony. We're going to do that through DNA evidence. I'm going to do that by talking to you a little bit about her motivation, why she did what she did. And at the end of the opening statement, we're going to talk about how she did it. So that'll be a kind of a sample roadmap to provide the jury with an understanding of how you're going to prove the case against Dorothy Gale. The next kind of important point to include your opening statement is to start off in a really compelling way. I'm sure you've all heard of the points of primacy and recency. Nowadays, people don't have very long attention span, and juries certainly don't have a very long attention span. You want to grab their attention from the very beginning, and the way you grab their attention is through a compelling impact statement. Okay? Over the course of this case, we're going to prove to you that Dorothy Gale took justice into her own hands when she meted out her own brand of justice, killing the Wicked Witch of the West. That's the way you might grab the jury's attention from the get-go, while also explaining to them your theme, you're going to come back to over the course of your opening statement and throughout the course of the case. The third point, and I put it in the middle, is it's really the most important point, and something that people just don't do, and attorneys just don't do, is you really want to tell a compelling story over the course of your opening statement. It should be a narrative. There should be a beginning, a middle, and an end. It should be both logical, compelling, and persuasive. So, you're not just going to get out there and say, over the course of this case, we're going to call this witness and that witness, and they're going to tell you this, and they're going to tell us this. No. You want to get out there and be dynamic and tell the jury an engaging story. Over the course of this case, we are going to prove to you that Dorothy Gale, along with her accomplices, the Tin Man, that cowardly lion, and the Scarecrow, banded together to journey not just down a yellow brick road, but a path of death and destruction that ultimately led to their brutal, savage murder of the Wicked Witch of the West. And you're going to want to flesh out the broad bones of that story with details that are told in a really compelling way, and the jury will remember so that when the evidence is presented, when the witnesses testify, when the documentary evidence is presented, they will link that back up to the compelling narrative that you told them at the outset. The fourth point is something that most attorneys totally avoid in their opening statement, but it's the best place to accomplish this goal, and that's identifying your weaknesses. Every case has a weakness. Usually that weakness is glaring, and what most inexperienced attorneys do, even some experienced attorneys, they spend the entire case trying to figure out ways to hide that weakness. That doesn't make any sense. Ultimately, that weakness is going to be exposed, and you're going to lose credibility in front of the jury unless you identify it to them really quickly, really early on. The best place to do it is the opening statement. In this case, what's the most obvious weakness? Well, you have a really, really unsympathetic victim. Who likes the Wicked Witch of the West? She is evil. She killed the Good Witch. She has a pretty nasty group of flying monkeys at her side. There's not too much to like about it, but that doesn't mean that Dorothy can kill her. So you're going to want to identify the fact that the Wicked Witch is not the most likable person, even an evil person, but then flip that and say the law does not allow people like Dorothy to take justice into their own hands and kill her. And in the same way that you want to start off with a compelling opening, you're going to want to end with a flourish. And by ending with a flourish, I don't mean that you're just going to use more compelling language. You should be doing that throughout. You're going to want to provide the jury with a really specific call to action that they will remember during the course of the case and that you can make reference to. For instance, you might say to them, at the end of this case, I'm going to come back to you and ask that you remind Dorothy Gale with your verdict that she's not in Kansas anymore. She's in the land of Oz, where the rule of the law holds, where an individual cannot simply fly in on a higher road and do what they please. At the end of this case, I'm going to ask that you return a verdict of guilty. So you're not asking yet, so you haven't provided the evidence, so it wouldn't be a very persuasive ask. But you're telling them that at the end of the case, you are going to come back and ask for that. And in the back of their minds, the juries will remember that call while they were providing your evidence. So just to recap, you want to use the opening statement to organize your case, give a really compelling opening, it's called an impact statement. You're going to want to tell your story in a really